So alcohol addiction is one of the greatest public health problems we have. It's the third most common cause of preventable death in the US. We have some options for treating patients with alcohol addiction, but they're very limited in what they can do. So what we're about here is trying to understand the biology of alcohol addiction and use that understanding to develop new treatments. Some of the research that we're doing here is aimed at trying to understand better. It turns out in clinical practice that naltrexone helps some patients quite well and other patients not so much. And so this takes us directly into the era of personalized medicine and pharmacogenetics. The next step is, of course, coming up with new medications. So if we've concluded that naltrexone really only helps one group that's characterized by their genetics, that really makes it that much more important to come up with novel mechanisms that can help the other patients. So that's what we're studying, and we have several such mechanisms under study right now. So there's a magic moment in this line of work, and it's when, you know, it used to be when I'd press the analyze button on some new data. Now it's most of the time a postdoc or some other coworker who will come with that analysis. But for a moment, you know something that is new and that no one else knows in the world. We really try to do translational research here. We really try to identify new mechanisms in our animal models and then take that to human studies as quickly as possible. If we have an interesting conversation in the lab one day, we can basically start designing the experiments or the clinical studies the next day and get to work on getting them going. That doesn't happen anywhere else, where you have to go through a grant application cycle and several revisions most of the time of those grants. So it's a very different timeline. Here, things happen in real time.